What I'm going to talk about in this video is the organization of the parasympathetic nervous system. Of course, this is a branch of the autonomic nervous system. And then we'll also look at the neurotransmitters and receptors used. So in the parasympathetic nervous system, the pathway consists of two neurons end to end, the preganglionic neuron. The cell body of the preganglionic neuron is located in the CNS, and then the axon extends out into the peripheral nervous system. These cell bodies are specifically located either in the brainstem or in the sacral region of the spinal cord. And since these pathways emerge from the cranial region or the sacral region, the parasympathetic nervous system can also be referred to as the craniosacral division. This preganglionic neuron will synapse with the postganglionic neuron. At a specific location called a ganglion. So this is our ganglion right here. And this is the postganglionic neuron. The postganglionic neuron will then synapse with the target cell, which could be a muscle cell or a gland cell. In terms of the neurotransmitter, a neurotransmitter called acetylcholine is released from the axon terminal of the preganglionic neuron, ACH for short, and this will bind to the nicotinic cholinergic receptors within the cell bodies of the postganglionic neuron. The postganglionic neuron also releases acetylcholine, but these will bind to a different type of receptor on the target cell. The target cell has muscarinic receptors, muscarinic cholinergic receptors. And these are G protein coupled receptors. All right, so to summarize, we have two neurons end to end. The preganglionic neuron emerges from the brainstem of the sacral region and will synapse with the postganglionic neuron at the ganglia. And then the postganglionic neuron will synapse with the target cell and therefore control activity of that target cell.